Hi, I'm Nick Schwaderer here on day two at Rails World. We've been having a great time interviewing some of our speakers. If you want to catch their talks, go on to the Rails and Rails World socials in 2 weeks, and they will be put up. And today I'm joined by yesterday's keynote, closing keynote speaker, Joe Masilotti. Joe, why don't you just, before I go off on a tangent, introduce yourself and maybe give a one-liner about your talk from yesterday.
Yeah, so I spoke about Hotwire Native and how the evolution of it through the past couple of years and how mobile apps are finally accessible to Ruby on Rails developers. I've been working with hybrid apps and mobile apps for a decade now. And just my book just got published a few days ago,
which
is really exciting. So, you know, I'm riding that high right now.
That's great. Well, I think it's so interesting, you know, learning about what you had to share. So I've seen the keynote, which is great before giving this interview. But maybe I'd be interested for the user or for the listeners to learn more about your journey into this specific area of the Ruby world. Like, where did you start and what kind of attracted you into this zone?
Yeah, so I got my start doing Android apps in college because I had an Android device and it was what you'd done. That's how I got interested in programming. And then I'd actually verged into iOS as my first like real career job.
Yeah.
And then I got hired by Mike D'Alessio at Pivotal Labs.
What?
And started writing Ruby and Rails and was like, whoa, this is so much better. And then it wasn't until 5 years later that Turbo Lynx Native came out and those worlds kind of collided. And I had this unique competitive advantage where I knew iOS and Android, but I was in the Rails ecosystem. And I was like, oh wow, I can build mobile apps in a really easy way. And then I started teaching it, and then I started writing about it, and you know, now I'm doing keynotes on it, so it's like it's been this awesome ride to get here today.
And you know, you make a pretty bold claim, like throughout your talk, the theme that I kind of felt is there's never been a better time to get into that Hotwire Native, you know, branching out into that native development for people who haven't done before. Why do you feel that way?
Yeah, I mean, I think tomorrow will be even better. I think that we're continuously improving this thing. It's finally got some momentum where we're seeing new features being added and it making it easier for Rails developers to get started. But why I think right now is an inflection point is with Hotwire Native, especially 1.2 and 1.3 that's coming out soon, the amount of boilerplate that's required to go from Rails app on a website to in the App Store has been driven down by like an order of magnitude.
Yeah.
100 lines of code, 150 lines of code for like a decent MVP is now 11 or 12 lines of code on these platforms. And it means that you can not become a mobile expert. Like you can continue just writing Rails and have this little shell of a native app and then drop down to native features when you need it. And that wasn't the thing last year, 2 years ago. And it's just like, it's this awesome feeling of seeing people pop up with their apps that have never touched mobile before.
Yeah.
And it's because of Rails powering the content of these apps.
Well, okay, so my next question for you then is for our engineers listening, and by the way, I am one of these engineers, worked many, many years, you know, with a job, Rails, Ruby, understand that ecosystem, and seen this happening on the side all along, but never dipped the toe, never took that first step into Hotwire Native development. I was like, you know what, Joe, you've convinced me. I think I've waited just long enough, and I want to do it today.
Yeah.
What would be that first step that you just say, do this to get started now?
Yeah, native.hotwire.dev. There are brand new documentation websites just for Hotwire Native now. It's like highest billing with Turbo and Stimulus, so you know it's part of the Hotwire ecosystem, but they each have their own getting started guide for iOS and for Android. And then they also link to the demo apps. So you get a feel for how easy it is to get started and pointing to a demo Rails server, running Xcode, running Android Studio. And then you try the demo apps and you see how powerful it is. And you get all that code that you can kind of parse through and understand at a deeper level without having to actually learn it or write it. And you can dissect it and change things and get comfortable without having to worry about knowing everything to get there. So that's always what I recommend first. It's free, you know, you can just pop on the website and download Xcode and you're good to go. From there, check out my book. I mean, my book is geared Hotwire Native for Rails developers. It's geared towards folks that have never touched a line of Swift or a line of Kotlin in their life. It walks you through getting started, you know, opening Xcode for the first time ever to getting an app with push notifications and native screens working by the end of it, and it assumes no native experience.
Well, that's wonderful, because again, like, if you've never looked in Xcode, if you've never written a single line of Swift, you know how to debug in Ruby,
yeah.
So like you can cross-apply some of these concepts
yeah.
for the people. But yeah, so to be clear, that's native.hotwire.dev.
Yeah.
And then that's native Hotwire development for Rails engineers. No, I got the name
side
wrong. Yeah. Say it again.
Hotwire native for Rails developers.
Well, thank you so much for all your work for the community, and thank you for speaking at this conference and just inspiring us to go into something that seems quite scary.
Yeah.
But I think the potential with mobile is so huge. Everything your mobile device can do, being able to access that from within Rails is fantastic. So thank you so much.
Yeah.
And, thank you for watching, and a big thank you to Shopify for sponsoring our on-site interview booth. Once again, keep your eye 2 weeks out on the Rails socials to watch the full talk.